Alright, here we've got the engine going in from the bottom. Hey, check it out, man. Pretty freaking sweet. Had to obviously remove the bumper, remove tie rods and all, swung it out of the way, left one side still intact, but you can see I got it in all by myself. The boom didn't go far enough back to actually bring the engine straight up, so I had to put some pressure on it. So this is pretty cool. Came up with this idea. Used a lot of these little stupid rubber strap thingies and just ran them back to the frame and pulled them back. I used about six of them for different tensions for different parts where I had to get the hub over the subframe. So there you go. Be another couple of pictures I took as I went along. I'm gonna pump up the back with a giant jack and a block of wood, get that bolted in, and then nail these in. So there you go. Here we are on the underside of the car. Engine finally bolted down. Everything's strapped in. You can see I got a pretty good straight line there, but I'm gonna have to shim that up just a little bit to get it straight right back to the axle. Also gonna have to have a double joint and to where it comes out here, and then have a bracket that goes across from here to here, and another joint to allow flexibility in the rear end to go up and down without hitting inside that tunnel right there. So that's pretty crucial. So that's going to be fun. I'm not sure what that's going to cost, but hey, motor and transmission's in. Let's take a look. All right, so nicely pretty painted motor. Pulled it in through the bottom. Still got to put the dust shield on. Still got to put the starter on, do some other things, but you can see how those biscuits are in there. They work. A little bit sketchy, but they work. So we'll see what happens. There it is. See, just had enough room.